right, this is a vignette that I wrote. I don't really know how to start a story that keeps changing, but I'm gonna try. One foot after the other, boy walks backwards, then two steps forward, then decides he take the high road. Still not sure if he's walking or driving, but he's definitely moving somewhere. He remembers he's a taxi cab driver. He remembers he has five more steps until the next few feet behind him turn into the clock on his dashboard, or his passengers drive him into a paint job. I like to draw you a picture of how the boy really feels, but he wears his story like a chip in the paint. And you know, cabs aren't relatively popular where he comes from to begin with, but when you have a rough paint job, the business becomes a little more constricting. There are people who call taxis, but they come just as they go. Boy got a new paint job to bring in a little more business, five steps forward on the high road back to town. Boy tried to turn his life around and the story kept changing. How do you give a script to a taxi cab driver, or his paint job, or the boy who took five steps back only to have taken one step forward from escaping and think the play is going to drive their passengers to joy? The entire time, the boy's feet had dyslexia and he didn't think there was anything wrong with that until his paint began to rust after not being properly maintained for a while, until his heart was made a transport for whenever he had the best business. Maybe he should have ran backwards and never stopped, because in the end, he would be so much farther ahead than the occupancy of your critics, but he's just a cab driver. Just a boy who doesn't know if the pavement is going to swallow him whole someday. You see, the boy never had mutual transactions. He most certainly drove the drive, but the only thing he had left at the end of the day was his last client's raincoat. Just enough to remember a body, to remember the sky and how he enjoyed the overcast when it wasn't in his mind, to remember what it was like to not be a cab driver, to not wear another man's raincoat to see if people will look at you the way you saw him in it when he was walking under the streetlights. You know, counting the absence of the sun on another man's head doesn't mean it's got to be brighter in the places you don't see it. You could open that raincoat, and a boy driving a rusted cab could be counting streetlights and make you the next mark in his paint job. Sidewalk crevices don't give you direction, nor street lamps or men in trench coats. Just put your hands to the steering wheel and take five steps back, only to find the place you need to be away from the feeling of trying to inhabit a raincoat. Next coat on a cab. The city can only swallow you if you let it.